Hi guys, good evening everyone. Welcome to the session and welcome to the India's most comprehensive preparation platform, Byju's Exam Prep. And once again, welcome to the GATE AMERS 2022 series, right, wherein the important topics, crucial topics of different subjects are being discussed. And right now, we are discussing up the control system. And today's topic of interest is the Bode plots. Yes, one topic where we can easily expect the questions in the examination, right? Good evening all, keep joining the session. Saradeep, good evening. Right. So yeah, let's begin up the session to discuss up the Bode plots. And to start off, good evening Juhi, this is a brief intro about me. This is your mentor and educator Rakesh. I have secured All India rank 9th in the GATE examination and completed my master's from the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Trained more than 50,000 students in my 11 years of journey. My major area of expertise is control, signal, digital and EMT in the technical domain, and in the general domain, I also deal with the maths and aptitude. Good evening, Ripanshi, Swapam. Right. Good evening, Sangeeta. Chalo. Okay. Yes, Juhi. Chalo guys, so this is what, as we have been telling you, the best faculty team, electronics and communication, the best faculties of the India associated with the Byju's exam prep, lots of experience, GATE toppers, ESE toppers, M.Tech from the best institutes of the nation. And these are the different batches available on the Byju's exam prep right now, the online classroom program, the Vision GATE, a batch for exclusive GATE. Rank up course, the very important practice course, those who want the quick practice and revision for the GATE 22 examination, and Vision 23, that's a long term course for the GATE and ESE aspirants, a full fledged course, right? Not directly, but you should, because they just mentioned integral, Saradeep, so we should go through it. Because they just mentioned definite integrals and integrals, so you should not skip it up, but questions very hardly, very rarely we see. Okay, good evening Sri Guru, Kabilan, Godwin, Sai Raja. Chalo guys, so and as always, let us get started with the questions. So we will revise the important formula and concepts of Bode plot through these questions. So we'll take up several questions for today. The first question on your screen, the approximate Bode magnitude plot of a minimum phase system is shown in the figure. Right. What is the transfer function of the system? What is the transfer function of the system? What is the transfer function of the system? Right. So let's get started. To transfer function of the system. So to derive the transfer function of the system, in general, what all we require? Just have a look at this. In general, what all we required considering first order? So we need to have the transfer function in the form of k 1 plus st1, 1 plus st2. There will be some zeros term divided by s raised to the power n poles at origin, and then some simple poles 1 plus sta, 1 plus stb, some simple pole terms can be there. Okay, so what all is there, how many poles, how many zeros will be known by the Bode plot. So now look into this Bode plot. Let's start everyone deriving, and once you are done, you can also comment on the options available on the screen. Good evening Komal, Raj, Upendra, Virendra, very good evening all. So have a look at this. So this is known as the initial part of the Bode plot, right? So initial part of the Bode plot has slope. What is the initial slope in any Bode plot? The initial slope in any Bode plot is given by minus 20 n decibel per decade, right? And here it is equal to 0, and that leads to the conclusion that n is equal to 0. Number of poles at origin will be equal to the 0, okay, where n is the number of poles at origin, this one. Now next, look into this frequency where the slope changes. Any frequency when the slope of the line changes is the corner frequency. Now how much is the slope changing here? Am I given the slope of this line? No, slope is not given, but can I calculate? Yes, definitely. So what is the slope of this line, guys? Everybody try to understand. What is the slope of this line? So see the magnitude change, 20 to 140, magnitude kitna change hua? 20 to 140, so magnitude is changing by magnitude is changing by 120 decibel for how much change in frequency? For how much change in frequency? 0.1 to 100 is like into 10 into 10. How many times? 100 times. Basically, into 10 into 10, 2 times. And a factor of 10 is known as 1 decade. A factor of 10 is known as 1 decade. So 120 decibel per 2 decade. 0.1 into 10 is 1, 1 into 10 is 10. A factor of 10 is decade. So this is total 2 decades, 2 times 10. So this slope is 60 decibel per decade. 120 for 2 decade or 60 decibel per 1 decade. Then what is the slope of this line? Isko bhi nikal lete hain. What is the slope here? So see the magnitude change. Magnitude change. Ye tha 120. 140 to 160 is 20. So this magnitude is changing by 20 decibel. For how much change in frequency? The frequency is changing from 10 to 100, and that is simply known as 1 decade. The frequency changes by 1 decade, so it is known as the 20 decibel per 1 decade only, right? And then finally, coming to the topmost section, it is a line parallel to the x-axis. Line parallel to the x-axis. So what is the slope of this line? Is simply 0. Now this is what is the value of the slopes. How much is the slope change? Ab slope changes ki baat karenge. Okay, how much will be the slope change, everybody? So what is this? The slope, which was 0, suddenly becomes 60. So slope change is positive due to a 0 term. For a single 0 term, how much is the slope change? Plus 20. For a single 0 term, the slope change is plus 20. But here the slope change is 60, directly 60. That means this location, the same location, there are 3 zeros. The same location, there will be the 3 zeros. Because whenever you have the 1 plus st term, 1 plus st term, there is a slope change of, due to the 1 plus st term, there is a slope change of how much? There is a slope change of positive 20 decibel per decade at omega c equal to 1 by t. That is known as the corner frequency. And similarly, if you have a simple pole term, 1 upon 1 plus st, that 1 upon 1 plus st produces a slope change of how much? It produces a slope change of minus 20 decibel per decade at corner frequency, which is 1 by t. At the corner frequency, which is 1 by t. Everybody, right? Chalo. Done. So now there were 3 zeros. Now come to this point. The slope was 60, now becomes 20. Slope was 60, now becomes 20. So what is the slope change? Slope decreased by 40. 60 se ho gaya 20, the slope reduced by 40. Decreased by 40 means 2 poles. Decreased means poles, and 40 means 2 poles. So this location represents 2 poles. Right, this location represents 2 poles. Finally, coming to this location, the slope was 20, positive 20, becoming 0. The slope again reduced by 20. Slope again reduced by 20, and slope reduces by 20 due to 1 pole. The slope reduces by 20 due to 1 pole, due to a single pole. So, yahan pe single pole hoga. Okay. Now, so we get how many st, 1 plus st terms are there. Right, corner frequency is 1 by t. So, whenever I want to calculate time constant, that will be 1 upon corner frequency. Achha. What is left is the value of k. Ab k kaise nikalenge? Okay, for the value of k, let me tell you the initial part formula. So there is one very important formula, not only for this question, in general you should always remember, that is the initial part formula. Initial part formula, which is written as minus 20 n log omega plus 20 log k. Minus 20 n log omega plus 20 log k is known as the initial part formula, where n is the number of poles at origin, as seen in this transfer function. N is the number of poles at the origin. If there are zeros at origin, okay, and one more thing already we discussed, let me write down again, then what is the initial slope known as? Initial slope is known as minus 20 n decibel per decade. Minus 20 n decibel per decade. Okay. Right. Now, if by chance there are zeros at origin, if there are m zeros rather than poles, if there are zeros at origin, if there are zeros at origin, so what is the magnitude is given by plus 20 m log omega. So minus 20 n ki jagah you will write down plus 20 m log omega plus 20 log k plus the 20 log k plus 20 m log omega plus 20 log k 20 m log omega plus 20 log k, right? Note down these formulas. Acha ji, so when I come to this initial part, so initial slope m equal to 0, and if the initial slope n equal to 0, we can use the formula, we can use the formula, what formula? M is equal to 20 log k. ठीक है, actually पूरा अगर लिखना चाहें, so you can take it like this, this formula should be m is equal to minus 20 n log omega plus 20 log k. This is the initial part formula, but here the n is 0, so I can write down m is equal to 20 log k, and hence we will get the value of k. What is the magnitude? 20. So 20 is equal to 20 log k, and solving it, k will be equal to 10. Right. Okay. Yes, yes. Good evening, Arvind. Chalo. So k ka value 10 aa gaya. It's all about just substitute these values here. So what will be my GSHS now? Everybody see. What will be the GSHS? It is equal to k. Now what is the value for k? Is 10. 1 plus st1. How many zeros are there? There is only one zero at point 1, but is repeated 3 times. Okay, and if there is a zero term, 1 plus st, what is the t? 1 upon corner frequency. 1 upon the frequency 0.1. So 1 plus s divided by 0.1, but that is a zero coming 3 times, the whole cube, divided by s raised to the power n. S power n, n is 0 here. N 0. Then there are poles. Where are the poles? Okay, there is a pole at 10, that is repeated twice. There is a pole at 100, that is only single time. So I will write down 1 plus s by 10, that is a pole twice, so square kar diya. Then I have 1 plus s by 100. Okay, just solve up the value. Just solve up the value. So this is equal to 10, s plus 0.1 ka whole cube upon 0.1 cube is divided by s power 0 is gone, so s plus 10 ka whole square divided by 10 square into s plus 100 is divided by 100. So 10 power upar 10 to 10 power 2 becomes 10 power 3, then again 100 to 10 power 5, 10 power 5 aur ye bhi upar jaake 10 power 3, so total 10 power 8, total constant outside is 10 power 8, s plus 0.1 whole cube upon s plus 10 whole square s plus 100, because the options were not in the time constant form, they were in the s plus a form, right? So accordingly, in the s plus a I have arranged, and the option that is matching is option number c. 10 power 8 is the overall constant term left, and s plus 0.1 ka whole cube, it is, this is wrong, option number c. Okay, option number C is the correct option. Okay, that's how it is. Chalo, moving ahead. Okay, moving ahead to the next question. Any confusions, please let me know here. If you have any confusions, this part is done. Anything else? Yeah, rest everything we have discussed, and we'll keep discussing. Any more points, we'll keep discussing. The magnitude frequency response of a control system is shown in the figure. The values of omega 1, omega 2 and m are respectively. The values of omega 1, omega 2 and m in dB are respectively equal to how much? Okay, so yahan pe, they don't want the transfer function, but they want some specific values, omega 1, omega 2 and magnitude. So I'll tell you some more points here. Look into this, guys. This is a slope of, yahan pe aate hain, is graph mein chalte. This is a slope of 20 dB per decade, and a slope of 20 dB per decade is also equal to a slope of 20 decibel per decade is also equal to a slope of 6 decibel per octave. 6 decibel per octave. So you should know both the units of slope, decibel per decade or decibel per octave. What is a decade? As I already told you, decade means a factor of 10. What is octave? Is a factor of 2. Don't confuse with octave. It's a factor of 2. So octave is a factor of 2. Now have a look into this graph. So within this graph, how much is this magnitude change? 20. The slope is 20 dB per decade. Okay, and that can also be written as 6 decibel per octave. What is the meaning of 6 decibel per octave? That the magnitude should change by 6 decibel for 1 octave change in frequency. Now look at this magnitude. How much is the magnitude changed? 20, say 26 plus 6. So magnitude has changed by plus 6 only, but that plus 6 should change by 1 octave of the frequency. This simply means that when you see on the frequency axis, what should be omega 1? Omega 1 should be 1 octave ahead of 10. 1 octave of 10, matlab 2 times 10, and that is equal to 20. So omega 1. So rather than using the slope formula and all, it is easy to go by this method. Sometimes decibel per octave. Right. Next. Now, coming to the next line, we need omega 2. So isko bhi do part mein break karenge. Just have a look. Okay, let us take this declining line again into two parts. Let us consider this portion. How much is the magnitude change up to this portion? 26 to 20. So, ye ho gaya minus 6. But the slope of the line is minus 20 decibel per decade, which is again equal to minus 6 decibel per octave. 20 decibel per decade is 6 decibel per octave. Acha. So this means that the magnitude should drop by 6 dB for 1 octave. So yes, magnitude has dropped by 6 dB for 1 octave up to this frequency. So that means this omega should also be 1 octave of the previous frequency. 1 octave ka matlab hai twice of the omega 1. That is twice of 20, and that is equal to the 40. So I get the value of omega, that is equal to 40. Right. Now look into this portion. So for this portion, how much is the magnitude drop? 20 se ka is 0. 20 se ka is 0. So magnitude drop is minus 20 decibel. Slope of the line is, you can use anyone, jo marzi ho. So now the slope of the line is minus 20 decibel per decade, which says that magnitude should drop by 20 decibel for 1 decade of the frequency. For 1 decade. That means omega 2 should be 1 decade. 1 decade means 10 times. 10 times omega. So 10 times 40, it is equal to 400. It is equal to the 400. Omega 2 bhi aagaya 400. Theek hai? That is equal to 400. So omega 1, omega 2 obtained. What is left? They are asking the magnitude also. Now how you will calculate the magnitude? Okay, for magnitude, let us use this line. Okay, what is the slope of this line? Same line it is, minus 20. Ah, sorry, there is a correction, guys. This frequency is 1000. That is wrongly printed. Omega 1, omega 2 aagaya. Make this frequency as 1000. There is a typo error here. Forgot to mention here. That is equal to 1000. Now, what is the slope of this line? What I am mentioning, the slope, same line, minus 20 decibel per decade. Acha, what is the formula for slope you will use? Guys, in Bode plot, what is the formula of slope you actually use? See, slope is actually y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Bode magnitude plot, y-axis means magnitude axis and x-axis means log omega. So, log of omega 2 minus log of omega 1. Right. We'll use this formula for the slope. So this slope minus 20 should be equal to m2 minus m1, m minus 0. I'm using this section of the line. Okay. इसको यूज कर रहे हैं. सो चेंज इन मैग्नीट्यूड m माइनस जीरो डिवाइडेड बाय लॉग ऑफ 1000 लॉग ऑफ ओमेगा 2 माइनस लॉग ऑफ दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी दैट इज 400. फ्रॉम हेयर यू गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑल्सो डन. What is the value of magnitude? So from here, magnitude is minus 20. Log A minus log B is log of A by B, and 1000 by 400 will become 2.5. So answer is minus 40 log of 2.5. Okay, let's just calculate. It's going to be nearly 8 decibel. It's going to turn out nearly 8 decibel. Kindly check it up. Nearly 8 decibel aa jayega. Okay. So correct answer is going to be standing at option number D. 20, 400 and minus 8 decibel. 20 log 2.5. 7.95 something should be coming up. Approximately 8 dB, right? See Rahul, वैसे both are important. EDC is clubbed with analog, you can say, and EMT has more weightage than EDC. So complete तो दोनों ही करना है. So November you start any of your choice. Start any of your choice. You know which you are more comfortable at. Okay, करना दोनों ही है, but don't take a chance. Start with the subject which you feel more confident, जिसमें आपको लगता है आप ज़्यादा score करोगे. EMT will have little more weightage as compared to pure EDC. We can't say, sometimes reverse भी हो जाता है, but EDC is very well connected with the, you know, analog. So, you know, both are very important. Chalo, done. That is what it is. Next question, guys. Yeah, Srinath, somewhere like that. Very close to 8 will be coming up. Okay, moving ahead with the next question on screen. Okay, the Bode magnitude asymptotic plot of a certain system is sketched in the below figure. The asymptote of minus 20 decibel per decade has a value of 0 dB. 0 dB means when it intersects the x-axis. Intersects the x-axis at omega 2 equal to 120. This is the value given as 120. The frequency omega 1 at which the two asymptotes intersect. Okay, this asymptote, minus 40 asymptote and minus 20 asymptote. Ye kahan intersect karenge? Right? Ye kahan intersect karenge? So see, the slope of this line is given. Okay, slope formula uses m2 minus m1 upon log omega 2 minus log omega 1. But here, omega 1 is not given and not even this magnitude. Ye bhi nahi given hai. Right. So using the slope formula minus 20, I may not be able to achieve one parameter. Because there are two missing things. What are the two missing things? Ek hai omega 1 also unknown. And what is the magnitude of this point? Let's say this magnitude is m. That is also not known to me. That is also not known to me. So using one equation of slope, we can't find out two variables. But what I will do is, this point is common even to minus 40 line. Okay, minus 40 line. This dotted line is the extended version of minus 40 line. So iska slope is... Oh, sorry. The slope of this line will also be minus 40. The slope of this dotted line is also minus 40. Okay, so now just... tally the calculations. We'll use the slope first, minus 40, and that is equal to m2 minus m1. What is the magnitude on x-axis? 0. Minus m1, that is minus m, divided by log of, ye frequency given hai 5, minus log of omega 1, right? From here, first of all, minus minus cancel, and what is the value of the magnitude? That is equal to 40 log of 5 divided by omega 1. 40 log 5 divided by omega 1. 40 log 5 divided by omega 1. ठीक है? Alright. Next. From this line, minus 20. ये तो हो गया minus 40 calculation. Now, minus 20 line. So, minus 20 will again be equal to, use this magnitude 0 and this is m. So, m2 minus m1. 0 minus m divided by log of omega 2. Okay, that is known to me. 120, directly write down the value. Log of 120 minus log of omega 1. Right. So from here also, minus minus cancelled, and what is the value of m is 20 log of 120 by omega 1. Okay, now rest is mathematics. both the magnitudes are the magnitudes of the same point, so equate kar denge. One side it is 40 log of 5 by omega 1, and the same magnitude is also equal to 20 log of 120 divided by omega 1. Okay, 20 40 seconds, so you are 2 log of 5 by omega 1 is equal to log of 120 by omega 1. 2 goes inside log, so that becomes the power log of 5 by omega 1 whole square is equal to log of 120 divided by omega 1. So 5 log log cancel, 5 square, that is 25 upon omega 1 square is 120 divided by omega 1. Solving up, you are getting the omega 1 will be equal to 25 is divided by 120. 25 is divided by 120. Let us see what is the calculation coming up. That is nearly 0.21. Option number D it is. Correct. That is the option number D. Chalo. Next question, moving ahead. Simple one, in a Bode magnitude plot, which of the following slopes would be exhibited at high frequency? Slope at high frequency by fourth order all pole system. Gate ka one mark question hai. Fourth order all pole system. What is the final slope formula? Thoda sa review karte jate hai. Okay. Final slope, also known as high frequency slope. Slope as omega tends to infinity. Okay. Is given by what formula? This is given by the formula minus 20 into P minus Z decibel per decade. Minus 20 P minus Z decibel per decade. Okay. Achha. Similarly, initial slope, also known as low frequency slope. They can discuss low frequency slope also. Right. Initial slope, low frequency slope, slope as the omega tends to zero. Slope as the omega tends to zero is given by what formula? That is simply minus. Okay. That is simply how much? Minus 20 into n. Just now we discussed in the beginning only. Minus 20 n. N is the number of poles at origin. Decibel per decade. This is what we already discussed in the beginning. Minus 20 n or plus 20 m. Depends. Poles at origin or zeros at origin. Poles at origin or zeros at origin. Whatever we discussed in the beginning. Any one of these formulas will come. Minus 20 n or plus 20 m. Okay. Achha, one more formula to be discussed. What is the final phase? Final phase, yeah, again high frequency phase, or once again I can say it is the phase as omega tends to infinity. What is that formula given by? What is this formula given by? This is given by the formula minus 90 degree into P minus Z. Minus 90 degree into P minus Z only and only for, this formula can be used only for minimum phase systems. For minimum phase systems, not everywhere. That is for the minimum phase system. Minimum phase system, right? Okay, Shan. Okay. Final phase formula is only for minimum phase systems, but the final slope formula is for minimum, non-minimum, both the types of systems. So how much it is here? Fourth order all pole. Fourth order means four poles. And how many zeros? Nil. All pole bola, na? Only poles. So minus 80. Answer is minus 80 decibel per decade. Finish. Okay, minus 80 decibel per decade. Simple question. Finish. One more. Gate 19, one mark question. The asymptotic Bode magnitude plot of a minimum phase transfer function is shown below. Consider the following two statements. The transfer function GS has three poles and one zero. And at very high frequency, the phase angle is minus 3 pi by 2. Which of the following statements is correct? Okay, it has three poles and one zero. So it's again a basic analysis of Bode plot. Simple one mark question. So what is this? This is known as minus 20. The initial slope is minus 20. That means n is equal to 1. Because the initial slope should be minus 20 n. So n is equal to 1. Number of poles at origin is equal to the 1. Okay, now the slope changes from n equal to 1 means, what is this n equal to 1? Ye bhi specify kar dete. N equal to 1 to hai, but what is this 1? This 1 is 1 pole at origin. What is this? Minus 20 to minus 40, slope change by minus 20. So one more pole. Minus 40 to minus 60, so here again the slope change, so this is one more pole. That's it. No other slope change. No slope change means no other pole zero. So how many poles are there? How many poles are there? 1, 2, 3. So the system having total 3 poles and how many zeros? Nil. Koi zeros dikhai nahi de raha. So we have the 3 poles. Transfer function has 3 poles and 1 zero. This is false. It has no zero. Statement 1 is false. Now at very high frequency, ye minimum phase hai. This is minimum phase. So at very high frequency, that is omega tending to infinity, the phase angle. High frequency phase means simply known as the final phase. Because it is minimum phase, so I can use the formula for final phase. Minus 90 degree into P minus Z. Minus 90 degree into 3 minus 0. That is minus 270 degree. Or also known as minus 3 pi by 2. Minus 3 pi by 2. So, ye ho gaya true. This is true. So, statement number 1 is false, but the statement number 2 is true. Basic analysis question. Right? Correct, Srinath, Ravi, Komal. Correct answer. It is the option number C. It is known as the option number C, everybody. Chalo, cool. Moving ahead. Yes, for the transfer function, 5s plus 4 upon s plus 0.25, s square plus 4s plus 25, what is the values of the constant gain term and the highest corner frequency? Highest corner frequency. Chalo. So, what are the things that we know up to this point? Ki if it is 1 plus st term, right? If it is 1 plus st term, what is the corner frequency? 1 by t. Right? Or if it is s plus a term, dekho, agar non-time constant form ho na, toh no need to convert into time constant. Corner frequency I can directly say. If it is s plus a, then the corner frequency equal to a. Why? Because I can take s a common and 1 plus s by a. Corner frequency is now 1 upon 1 by a, which is equal to a. Thik hai? Ye directly likh sakte. Achha ji. Thik hai? Achha. If it is 1 upon 1 plus st, simple pole, or 1 upon s plus a term. So corner frequency formula for a pole and zero, corner frequency is same, 1 upon t, or here also I can say corner frequency a. That is for first order zero or first order pole. Now coming to the second order term. What is a standard second order term? What is the standard second order term will be written as omega n square upon s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. Okay. What is the corner frequency for this? The corner frequency, I'm just giving you the results, derive nahi kar rahe hain. The corner frequency for a standard second order term is omega n. Right. And at the corner frequency, how much is the slope change? There will be a slope change of minus 40 decibel per decade. Minus 40 decibel per decade. This is what you should know for the standard second order term. Now let's come to this numerical question. So what is the GS given to me? Everybody, just let's see together. Kitna hai 5s plus 4. 5s plus 4 is divided by ss plus 0.25, s plus 0.25, s square plus 4s plus 25. S square plus 4s plus 25. S square plus 4s plus 25. Correct. Now, first of all, I need to convert into the standard form. First of all, I need to convert. Corner frequency to direct likh lete hain. Achha. Forget the standard form and all. What are the corner frequencies? What are the corner frequencies? Have a see. The corner frequency due to the zeros. S plus A hai to corner frequency A. Due to the poles. S plus 0.25. So corner frequency is 0.25. Second order term S square plus 4S plus 25. S square plus 4s plus 25. So everybody knows that this is the value of omega n square. Omega n square 25 hai, toh omega n is 5. So what is the corner frequency for second order term? It is equal to omega n and hence it is 5. Hence it is 5. So which is the highest? Which is the highest? So highest corner frequency is 5. Okay. Highest corner frequency is 5. But what is the constant gain term? Whenever they say constant gain term, means the constant gain term in the standard form. Bode plot mein standard form wala hi constant k mana jayega. So this is equal to 5. S plus 4 is not the standard form. So 4 has to be taken outside. So I get 1 plus s by 4. S plus 0.25 is not the standard term. So 0.25 bahar aayega. 1 plus st is the standard form. So 1 plus s upon 0.25. S square plus 4s plus 25 is not the standard form. What is the standard form for second order? If it is S square plus 4s plus 25 plus omega n square, so there has to be omega n square in the numerator. But there is no 25. So if I multiply by 25, I will also have to divide by 25. Right? So now, what are the constant terms? 5 into 4 divided by 0.25 into 25. Okay, rest is okay. One rest, you have the transfer function 1 plus s by 4, that is 1 plus 0.25s divided by 1 plus 4s is multiplied by 25 upon s square plus 4s plus 25. This is the value of the constant gain term. This is the value of the constant gain term. How much it is? 5 fours are 20 upon 0.25, 80, 80 upon 25. 3.2. Okay, so whenever they want to discuss the constant gain term, all the terms should be in the standard form. What is the standard form for a first order term? It is 1 plus st. This is known as standard form. Okay, this side it is a standard form. Okay, 1 plus st and 1 upon 1 plus st, time constant form. What is the standard form for second order term? Okay, the normal prototype transfer function jo hum study karte hain transient mein. Omega n square upon s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. The corner frequency is omega n. Okay. Chalo. Moving ahead to the next question. Okay, the Bode plot of a transfer function is given below. What is the steady state error corresponding to ramp input for the given control system? Steady state error पे भी discussion हो सकता है. What is the steady state error corresponding to ramp input for the given control system? For the given control system. For the given control system. Check करते हैं. Right. So see. What is the initial slope? Minus 20. Minus 20 corresponds to minus 20 n. Minus 20 n compare kiya n equal to 1. Right? N equal to 1 hai, it means it is a type 1 system. Number of poles of GS at origin. Assuming unity feedback. Okay? Of course, assuming unity feedback. It is a type 1 system. Now, because it is a type 1 system, So what is the steady state error for which input? For ramp input. What is the steady state error for ramp input? The steady state error for ramp input is given by 1 upon KV, and KV is equal to K of the standard form. KV is equal to which K? The K of standard form. And I told you once again, whatever is the K we are getting from the Bode plot, it is the standard form only. Okay. KV is equal to K in the standard form. So that means to find out the steady state error, what do we only require is the value of K. Now how to find out the K? Question mark is how to find out the value of K. 1 upon K to karna hai, how to find out the K? So K can be obtained by the initial part. K nikalna hai and you can find it by the initial part. From the initial part. So there is one important formula jo ki maine bola hai. What is the initial part formula? What is the initial part formula? Initial part formula minus 20 n log omega plus 20 log k jo first question mein use bhi kiya tha. So what is the value of n here is 1, and let us use what magnitude? What is the initial part, by the way? Initial part is the part up to the first corner frequency. What is the initial part? Initial part is the part of the Bode plot up to the first corner frequency. Okay, so this is corner frequency, is the frequency where slope change. So wo dekh ke samajh mein aa jata hai. So here this is what is the initial part. Okay, so omega 1 is not known. So we can use 0.1, magnitude is 32. We can use this value. We can use this value. Koi bhi point jahan pe data given ho. So magnitude is 32 at 0.1. So use magnitude equal to 32 and the omega equal to 0.1. Right. So 32 is minus 20, n ka value 1 hai, log of 0.1 plus 20 log k. So hence k will be obtained, isn't it? Hence k ka value aa jayega. So 32 is log 0.1 is minus 1, so minus minus plus, ye ho gaya 20 plus 20 log k. So the value of 20 log k, 32 minus 20 is equal to 12. K solve it up, 20 log 2 6 hota hai, so this should be 20 log 4. K approximately 4. K will be approximately equal to the 4. So your answer is, 1 by 4, and that is 0.25, option number C. Option number C, everybody. Steady state error from the Bode plot. Okay. They can discuss the steady state error from the Bode plot, right? Chalo. All right. Steady state error from the Bode plot. Now one more thing I want to discuss here. Usko hum le lete hain yahan pe pehle. Let us take that one more thing coming up here first. Ye bhi important hai. The asymptotic Bode phase plot. The asymptotic Bode phase plot of GS equal to K upon S plus 0.1, S plus 10, S plus P1. With K and P1 both positive is shown below. What is the value for P1? The asymptotic Bode phase plot. Now what are the asymptotic Bode phase plots? Point ye hai. What are the asymptotic Bode phase plot? Let me give you the brief idea about that. The asymptotic Bode phase plot before going forward. Okay. The asymptotic Bode phase plot. So we'll solve this question, but before that, let's come up. What is the asymptotic Bode phase plots? I'll give you a very quick idea. Okay, long time back, I have taken a separate session of this on YouTube, so you can find it up right now, but I will just give you a very quick idea. Asymptotic Bode phase plot. Second approximation rule. This is known as second approximation rule.
Okay, so if the GS is 1 plus ST, or if the GS is 1 upon 1 plus ST. Dono dekhenge yahan pe. Let's see both. Right. Initial slope crosses to 0 dB. I'll tell you, Srinath. Let me complete this. I'll tell you. Okay? I'll tell you. Uska ek straightforward formula hai. Okay, so GS is 1 plus ST or GS is 1 upon 1 plus ST. Let me tell you this plots. So what is the plot actually? The asymptotic phase plot, second approximation rule ke according. So everybody knows that for 1 plus ST, corner frequency is 1 by T. Corner frequency is 1 by T. Let us write down the same. Corner frequency is 1 by T. Okay. क्या करना है आपको? Take a frequency which is 1/10 of the corner frequency and take the frequency which is 10 times the corner frequency. The phase is 0 up to the 1/10th point. Up to 1/10th corner frequency, the phase will be 0. It increases linearly up to 10 times the corner frequency. And thereafter, again, it becomes constant, that is equal to 90 degree. Final phase. The final phase will be 90 degree. Na? It's only a simple zero term. Right? This is 90 degree. This is 0 degree. And the phase at the corner frequency, the value of the phase at the corner frequency is exactly equal to 45 degree. This is equal to 45 degree. The slope of this line is, the slope of this line is known as plus 45 degree per decade. Okay. How this is coming in and all, if you want derivation. So I have taken a full session only on the asymptotic phase plot earlier on the YouTube. So it will be there somewhere in the playlist. You can search it up. And for the pole term, it will just be opposite of it. It will just be opposite of it. It will be 0 till 1/10th of the corner frequency. It decreases and it becomes constant, that is minus 90 degree. Minus 90 degree, 0 degree. Okay. These are the same points. This is 1/10th of the corner frequency. Let's suppose this is the corner frequency. And I did not mention this point. Isko bhi note kar dete hain. This is 10 times the corner frequency. Again, this line is having the slope of minus 45 degree per decade. Minus 45 degree per decade, right? This is what you should know about the asymptotic Bode phase plot second approximation rule. Achha. So what is the point to be noted here? That there is no slope change at the corner frequency. There is no slope change at the corner frequency. In the magnitude plot, there is a slope change at corner frequency. But here, there is no slope change at the corner frequency. Right? But there is a slope change at 1/10th of the corner frequency. And that is a slope change of plus 45. Okay, ye tha na 0. 0 say it becomes a slope of plus 45. And then finally, parallel to x-axis. Matlab again, slope is 0. Again, slope is 0. So again, there is a slope change of minus 45. Plus 45 to 0 means minus 45 at 10 times. You should note down the slope changes point, right? You should just remember, you don't have to remember the graph, You should have to just remember the slope changes conclusion. The slope changes conclusion for 1 plus st. The slope changes conclusion for 1 upon 1 plus st. What are the conclusions? Okay. There is a slope change of plus 45 degree per decade at 1/10 of the corner frequency. And dekho na, plus 45 and then again reduces to 0 means change kitna hua? Change is minus 45 degree at 10 times the corner frequency. And for the pole term, just reverse the result. Just reverse the result. That is minus 45 degree per decade at the 1 by 10th point. Minus 45. Ye raha na? From 0, it reduces to minus 45. And then again becomes 0. Means again increased by 45. So there is a plus 45 degree change. Increase of 45 at the 10 times point. At the 10 times point. Okay. Okay, now let us come back to this question. So what is available here? First, let us write down the slopes of every section of the line. Slopes are not mentioned. So this is the asymptotic phase plot is given to me. What is the slope of every line here? See, this is the slope change. This is the magnitude, this is the phase change 0 to minus 45. Matlab the phase change by 45 degree, decrease by 45 degree and frequency 0.01 to 0.1. That is one decade. The frequency is into 10. So what is the slope of this line means? The slope of this line is minus 45 degree changing for one decade. So minus 45 degree per decade. Okay. Now cover up this portion. Is line ko cover up karenge. So how much is the phase dropping? Minus 45 to minus 225. Okay. So minus 180. This is a drop of minus 180 degree. How much is the frequency change? Into 10 into 10, 2 decades. Okay, frequency changing by 2 decades. So what is the slope of this line? The slope of this line is minus 180 degree per 2 decade. So eventually minus of 90 degree per decade. Minus 90 degree per decade, right? What is this again? The last section. See the phase, minus 225 say minus 270. So again dropped by minus 45 degree and frequency is 10 to 100. That is one decade only. So what is the slope of this line? What is the slope of this line? Minus 45 degree per decade. Okay, the final slope becoming zero again. Parallel to x-axis. Now, the transfer function has been given to me and it is only containing poles, poles, poles. So what are the slope changes point? Okay. What are the slope changes point? According to the transfer function, what are the slope changes point? So if it is a pole term, if it is a pole term, this conclusion is important. That's it. Aapko keval conclusions dhyan rakhna hai. So minus 45 change at 1/10 corner frequency plus 45 change at 10 times corner frequency. By the way, what are the corner frequencies? Okay, by the way, pehle hum corner frequency likhte hain. So what are the corner frequencies here? Right, that is due to the poles and that is the corner frequency of S plus A hai na? So A is the corner frequency. So 0.1, then 10 and then P1. These are the three corner frequencies. And now I will write down the slope changes point. Now I will discuss the slope changes point. So slope change of minus 45 degree per decade at omega equal to 1/10 of the corner frequency. And there will be a slope change of plus 45 degree per decade at the frequency 10 times the corner frequency. So 1/10 of the corner frequencies will become 0.01. 1/10 of 10 is 1. 1/10 of P1 is P1 divided by 10. Here 10 times of 0.1 will be 1, 10 times of 10 will be 100, 10 times of P1 will be 10 P1. What are you able to see eventually?
वॉट आर यू एबल टू सी इवेंचुअली, इसको एक बार थोड़ा सा और नीट एंड क्लीन लिख देते हैं. दिस इज 0.01, देन 1/10 of 10 इज 1, एंड देन 1/10 of P1 इज P1/10. सो वॉट आई एम एबल टू सी इवेंचुअली दैट 1 and 1, द फिगर 1 इज अपियरिंग बोथ द प्लेसेस. वॉट इज द मीनिंग इफ द फिगर 1 इज अपियरिंग एट बोथ द प्लेसेस? ओके, सो देर इज अ चेंज ऑफ +45 एज वेल एज -45 एट द सेम पॉइंट. मतलब इफेक्टिवली देर इज नो स्लोप चेंज, इट इज कैंसल्ड आउट. डू यू सी एनी स्लोप चेंज एट 1? नो, इट इज जस्ट अ कंटिन्यूस स्ट्रेट लाइन. यहां पे कोई बेंडिंग नहीं है. स्लोप चेंज मतलब इट शुड आइदर बेंड डाउनवर्ड्स और बेंड अपवर्ड्स. देर इज नो स्लोप चेंज हियर, इट कैंसल्ड अवे. सो नाउ एट 0.01 एंड P1/10 देर शुड बी अ स्लोप चेंज ऑफ -45. सो ध्यान देना, this was slope 0, now becoming -45. So this is a slope change of 0.01. That is already known. -45 to what is the slope now? -90. -45 to slope is -90. So the slope decreased. So the slope decreased by -45. And it should decrease at P1/10. That means this value should be P1/10. Right. Let's go ahead. Now going ahead. -90 slope now becoming -45. Slope increased by +45. +45 increase should occur at 110p. 110p1. Right. So that means this value should be equal to 10p1. And then look into the final section. -45 to slope 0 means slope increased by 45. And slope increase of 45 should occur at the 100. This is given value. This is already we know. So we can calculate the p1 either by this value. 10p1 equal to 10. Meaning P1 equal to 1 is the answer. Or you can calculate from here. P1/10 is 0.1. So P1 is 1. Kahi se bhi nikal sakte. I can use any of these points. And my answer, numerical answer type is 1. The value of P1 is 1. The pole is at -1. Okay, this is a question on asymptotic phase plot discussed by IISc Bangalore in gate 16 2 marks. Discussed by the IISc Bangalore in the gate 16 for the 2 marks, right? Everybody, all right, okay, chalo, cool guys. So time is 8 p.m. That's it for the session. Yeah, Srinath, you were asking me, so I'll tell you your query as well. So what was the initial part formula? I'll reply to Srinath. What was the initial part formula? Magnitude is -20 n log omega plus 20 log k. -20 n log omega plus 20 log k. And this initial part intersects the 0 dB axis, intersects the 0 dB axis at the frequency omega, which is k raised to the power 1 by n. Which is k raised to the power 1 by n. So suppose they ask you the value of k, so k will become omega power n. If you know the 0 dB axis intersects at some omega, if that omega is known, k is equal to omega power n. N is the type of the system. So you can calculate for any of the case, type 0, type 1, type 2, etc. Right, so like you are asking Srinath for type 2, so k will become omega square, where omega is the 0 dB cutting point. 0 dB cutting point. Okay. Alright. So, as you know, this is alternate classes series. So, next class will be now on Thursday, where we will go towards the continuation of this. Some more questions based on Nyquist-Bode plots, but in terms of gain and phase margin. And not only Nyquist-Bode plots, but the direct question of gain phase margins will also be discussed. So, Thursday class will be on the gain phase margin calculations. Thursday's class will be on the gain and the phase margin calculations. Okay, the continuation of this, everything is related. Okay, yeah, that is on Thursday. And alternate may, we are having the EMT, that is on the other channel of the Byju's. So if you are also eager to revise and practice questions of EMT, so tomorrow, Wednesday, same time, timing will be same. Okay, but subject and channel will be different. That is in the Byju's Hindi channel. Tomorrow will be waveguides questions. Waveguides ke question honge. In the EMT, last class I took transmission line questions, and tomorrow I'll be taking waveguides questions, right? So alternate control on this channel, English channel, alternate EMT on the Hindi channel, both are at 7 p.m. I'll be taking two subjects but on different channels, right?
So those who want the waveguides question practice, they can join me tomorrow 7 PM on the Byju's Gate and ESE Champions Hindi channel. I will share you the link on the Telegram as well. Okay guys, yeah, thank you, bye bye, stay safe, take care.